Hello friends, from our school days, we have been taught and observed that spontaneously fluid flows from higher pressure region to lower pressure region. But what is the actual physics behind that? Now let's look into that phenomena more closely. Let's start with an example. Take a nozzle. At section A, pressure is P1 and velocity is V1. At section B, pressure is P2 and velocity is V2. Now, as particle moving from section A to section B, velocity of particle increases and pressure decreases. That means pressure at section A is higher than pressure at section B. Here, fluid flows from higher pressure region to lower pressure region, which is the obvious case. But now, look at the variation of flow properties and diffuser. Pressure at section A is P1, velocity is V1, and at section B, pressure is P2 and velocity is V2. As the particles moving from section A to section B, pressure increases and velocity decreases. Here, fluid flows from low pressure region to high pressure region. That is not the obvious case. Strange, isn't it? Actually, the pressures P1 and P2, which we are talking here in these examples, are static pressure. And the statement, spontaneously fluid flows from higher pressure region to lower pressure region, is concerned with the total stagnation pressure, not the static pressure. So, total stagnation pressure at section A is always higher than the total stagnation pressure at section B, in case of nozzle as well as in case of diffuser. So, now the question is, what is the difference between static pressure and stagnation pressure? Let us understand these pressures with one funny example. Imagine that you have jumped into a pipe of sufficiently large diameter through which water is flowing. Now consider yourself to be moving with the flow of water with the same velocity of particles. Hence, there is no relative motion between your body and surrounding water particles. In this circumstance, the pressure that is experienced by your body is called static pressure. Now, imagine that during your travel within the pipe, one of your leg got stuck at some point and now you are no more moving with the water. But water still keeps on moving with the same velocity and flows over your body. And hence, your body will experience higher pressure compared to the previous case. And this higher pressure is called stagnation pressure. Now, let's talk about the methods to measure these pressures. One way to measure static pressure would be to drill a hole in a flat surface and fasten a piezometer tube. And now consider a small tube inserted into the flow pointing upstream is called pitot tube.
In each tube, the level of fluid indicates the intensity of pressure.
The level of fluid in piezometer and pitot tube is same. Now, let us open gate from both the sides. Particles moving from upstream to the downstream with some velocity V. As particle brought to the rest at the tip of pitot tube, the kinetic energy of particle is converted into pressure energy at tip of pitot tube. Fluid in the pitot tube, including the tip of pitot tube, will be stationary, and the pressure experienced at that point is called stagnation pressure. The pressure difference between stagnation pressure and static pressure is called dynamic pressure, and dynamic pressure is because of the kinetic energy of fluid.
If you have any query regarding this, kindly post it in comment section below. And in next video, we will talk about mathematical relationship between all these three pressures. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video and subscribe for more updates. Thank you.